Well, hello, good morning to everybody. We're going to be hopping right into this one. Oh, a very cold morning. A lot of snow. We're expecting a blizzard. Gonna do a little bit of streaming. Time to just sit back and relax. So, gonna keep an eye on and see what happens in Khazaria. It'll sort of determine our next moves. We have recovered. And for right now, we're just going to hold ourselves our first real event, which is right here, an activity. We're going to hold ourselves a feast. Right in Moscow. So welcome back to Blood in the Snow. This is a series about the birth and rise of Russia. Right now we are the Norse, just relaxing and enjoying our time. We are no longer severely wounded, we are just wounded. Depending on what happens in Khazaria, like if it holds itself together and doesn't fall apart, we will probably join Khazaria and just try to claim the territory that we need to form this kingdom right here, and then try to break it apart from the inside. The Khazars are a pretty powerful force in the beginning of the game. Just like how the Arabian Empire is. Even though it has lost its Persian territory. Looks like they ended the looks like they ended the struggle, and I'm thinking they did Iranian resurgence. That's what it looks like. And we ended up losing more prestige. Jeez. Delightful. And losing more prestige, of course. Why not? Well, it's not as bad as it used to be. So we're going to not declare war yet. And we can't even go off on a raid because we somehow got pulled into this war. I must have clicked on a button without realizing it. Europe looks like a bunch of messed up. Maybe we will have another consolidation of Upper and Lower Francia, like we did last time. Be nice if we had a formation of Francia. Still need to figure out how come the Holy Roman Empire even spawned in to start out with. We're just gonna go down and beat up some forces over here. Taking a bigger beating than I like right here. And the ally didn't even come up to help. Of course not. There's an African lord all the way up here, actually. That's interesting. That's really interesting. And we have people trying to raid Moscow again. But we've gained Founder, so now we can go over and start. Working our way to becoming a celibate. Stop having so many kids. Accept their generous gifts. So our entire territory has converted into, well, not converted, but has changed to Nordic culture, and it's converted to our religion. Do we have another? Yeah, we do. We have another Norse lord has taken up residence in Russia. Kiev is on its way to. Looks like it's gonna be forming the actual kingdom of the Rus. Oh, good. We can actually work on taking out. They broke away, so we can capture these territories here, which we need them all for the kingdom. ...1,000 prestige, and we can launch and take all that. Another daughter. We will educate her. Shape him in my image. And we're gonna continue until we wipe out that guy's bloodline. Murder one of my sons. We're gonna wipe out his entire family. So quickly. Ragnar. Basically anybody we can get. Come and join us. Being raided. I really need the prestige right now, so we'll go against the clergy. It's not like it's going to be too big of an issue. Bummus got the war goal captured. How is he in control of the army? That sucks. That's my own fault, though. He's definitely not a strong ruler, apparently. Even though he's got amazing stats. Just not getting the results needed. And we've wiped out that family. Wiped out an entire bloodline right there. Now the harsh Russian winter is starting to come into play. Hopefully with our ally. And we've got ourselves a grandson, which we will educate. Hopefully make him a fine warrior. The Arab Empire is really invading into the Eastern Romans. Almost have this under our control. Let's go up and hit this army. Bring all of our allies in on this. Except for Ragnar, apparently. He just wants to go out and fight over here. Let's see, where is the... It's all the way over there. marshal has died, so we definitely want to make sure we have a better marshal. Another one of our daughters came of age. Have one of our daughters. Nah, I won't take it. What about Poland? And they're betrothed. This one I'll have to do. Just more allies we can pull into future conflicts. Definitely need to get our army bigger. Light of the Ancestors. Outside of moving us over and basically grabbing us this little home, Apnir is kind of a meh character in what he's done. Nice if some of our other allies would come help us with this. Looks like one of our allies is being pulled away to a different war. Which is interesting. And our allies have arrived to help us. Now we finally have this full duchy. Let's turn it Norse. And convert it. Now we can work on pushing out and gathering some of the other territories. Recovering our force will be our first goal, and then I think we'll go over here and see if we can, like, do any raiding opportunities. Might be able to. Could raid into Bulgaria. For some reason that's glitched out, interestingly. Don't know why. That just means that Rome's gonna be really weakened. Is Rome also glitched? Yeah, it's also glitched too. That's interesting. So is London. We've almost lost all of our adventurers at this point. But that's fine. Just go raiding and hit anybody we can. Throw them in jail. They're a traitor. We can we can raise up a new runestone, which is going to be very helpful to our current situation. Good daughter. convert this to Norse. Let's see, who else can we hit? Let's just move back over this way. I think we'll go pay the Anglo-Saxons a visit. Build up a trade port. Which will be good for right there. Let's go pay Britain a visit. A little remnant of Kent right here. Burn it down. Collect some more. Our Jarl should be leading each one of these. Let's bring the boundless plunder. Back to Moscow. Ragnar has died. He's died super early. Go a nice little input into our prestige. Another trade port here would be good. Trade along the rivers. And another war camp. I'm gonna give ourselves some veterans. The veterans sound nice. Let's place them here. Let's put these in Moscow. Here. And we want the right bowman. Which we'll put up here. We'll take another group of archers. There we go, that should increase. We definitely have the manpower advantage, we just don't have the one advantage. We're definitely bringing in a healthy amount of money. Now we can declare war. Grab a territory we need. And the Catholics King Crusade. Try to beat them down. I definitely need my ally over here. Now here's a little bit of internal mechanics, being that we now have converted Norse culture over here, we are going to get some new Nordic characters into the character pool. So we're in a pretty big character pool area. Our ally is going to come over here soon. There we go. We're just going to run him down. Grand temples. We don't really have anything unique over here outside of the Kavian Gate. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of nothing until you start getting like over this way. Okay, that's interesting. Break down these sieges. Stop going to war whenever I'm at war. carefree. Go with this and work on getting ourselves a prestige. So I want to try to get the kingdom invasion. How much do we need to form this kingdom? Technically, we actually have enough. We just need to form another duchy. So after we finish this war, we could technically form the kingdom. So we need to grab the war goal. Now, since our entire kingdom is actually outside of the cultural area of, what is the Russian cultures, basically the East Slavs, we are pretty good to just turn this entire area Norse, which is actually more ideal, and then whenever we hybridize with one of these, to form the Rus. We're gonna have a lot better of a chance. Let's call in another, ally and see what we can do with them. So what we need to do now is just keep this war score going up. And not die. Ally must have engaged first. I was actually going to throw that into Crusader Wars, but too late. Definitely gonna chase him down. Only need to hit one of their armies, the other one's an ally, so they won't actually contribute. We're quite far in the frontiers of Europe. There's the Euro Mountains. So historically, what Russia did is it expanded first its borders to the Euro Mountains, which the Euro Mountains make a natural border against basically the adversaries here in the steppe region. Or it would if it didn't have a giant open section that is the steppe itself. Which basically makes a natural highway going straight here. And that's basically what led to the conquest of the East. If we can outrun their siege, which it doesn't look like we're going to be able to. We are infirm. We'll become drunk, oh well. There we go. Form this title, which should then let us form the kingdom. We're gonna copy that and convert it to the land of Moskva. Moskva. And Moskva. So there we go. I think I spelt that wrong. Yeah, I did. Give me a second. That's Moskva, and that is Moscow. What we spelled before. There we go. Now let's take a look at our royal court that we get to enjoy for a while. Maybe it's because we are outside of Scandinavia, but I thought for sure that would be a Nordic court. Regardless, we've got ourselves a nice little court right here. And we shouldn't worry about our land breaking up right now, though we will probably have a civil war whenever our character dies. Which he's made it to 70, so that's something. Let's see if our original character is still alive. One that we played in the last playthrough. He did die, and he hasn't expanded any territory. This was the dynasty that we played as the last time. Whenever we were doing our Roman playthrough. I wonder, will you... allow us. Yeah, definitely not. I was gonna say that'd be interesting. Looks like Charlemagne decided to do a little bit of something. And grab some territory in Saxony. Now, in actual history, he should have hold of this entire area here. Go ahead and pick the maximum for our court grandeur. Groom to rule. All of our children will get a plus one or a plus three. And we need an Aquitarian. We give ourselves I need a banner. Bjorn with his fancy beard. A Now we're at the maximum of this character's domain. But we want to make sure we hold the actual Duchy of Moskva. We are going to turn Moscow into the Third Rome. And finally, the Arab Empire is broken apart. Right here is the Sunni Caliphate. So all that's left of the Caliph's power. Oh, the Sassanids are still around. Tehran. Mongolia is broken independent. Western Zhao. Control the Chow. Son. Well, this is a suitable alliance for us. If we can get enough, we will launch a kingdom invasion. Try to grab this territory here. Odin protects us. When we capture all of this area, then we can descend down towards Kiev and take the actual capital of the Rus. Found the capital of the Rus. I like this dynasty banner. Not the biggest fan of the triangle banners, but this one, it works for this one. Got ourselves some decent buildings. And our wife from the House of Masava. Still alive. She was a good bit younger than us. This is definitely a first starting character that was pretty good. We started with him in his 30s, so definitely fairly nice. And speaking of, he has died, and now we have Bjorn. And I think this is a good place to stop. Bjorn is definitely definitely gonna have a few things to deal with. He is wounded. He has one leg. And it's not the one that has Gangrot. And we need to take out the territories owned by our brothers. Him we can go ahead and deal with. We're just going to execute. And sacrifice him. It'd be harder to murder our other brothers. But at least that's one down. Take a little bit and get ourselves up there more. Educate him. When did he switch to the culture? That's interesting. And this is where we will pick up later today or tomorrow. Depends on what I'll be doing, but we will be dealing with our brothers and working on pushing ourselves to the full borders of our kingdoms and setting up our first actual vassals. Definitely something that we will have to deal with. Though we could launch an actual invasion right here. And then take these two out independently. But we're gonna have to. We'll definitely see about that, and hopefully Bjorn survives. It's definitely not looking the best, let's put it that way. Put our banner in the right spot. Save one more time, make sure it doesn't, you know, have a problem. And we'll see you all later, you alligators. Bye-bye now. Let's see if we got anybody to raid. Nobody that smaller. Well, and with that, we will see you later, you alligators. Bye-bye now.